Hi, welcome back. This video is all about creating your first list. So this is how your homepage is going to look like after you sign up, and you'll see a few options on top, which is list, reports and drafts. So we want to create a list for you. List is nothing but it's just like a campaign. It's like a, let's say if you're running Facebook ads, okay, and for one of the products that you're trying to sell, or for one of the courses that you're trying to sell. So you can maintain a separate list for that. And on the other hand, you're trying to sell some other course and you can maintain a different list. So list is basically different campaigns that you're trying to run, and you segregate the customers according to the way they've got into the funnel, okay? Now, if I click on the list, this is how the dashboard is going to look like. So to create your first list, you have to go and just click on the create list button, okay? And just let's say type it out, email marketing. It has to go under with an underscore, email marketing. Class test. Okay, and we just go and hit the create button. It's as easy as that. That's it. So your list is created, email marketing class test. Okay, now if you want to add contact, you just click on, there are two ways if you want to add contacts. You just click here and you go to add contacts. Here it's going to ask you two ways, okay, one by one manually. So if you have about 10-15 email lists that you can add automatically, you can just do it one by one, but it's a time consuming process. But the best way is to just go and upload a CSV file, right? Just maintain one column with an email as the title, and then you try to put all the email IDs into it, and just try to upload that file. It will automatically manually upload all the contacts into it. But make sure you don't buy database from outside. Otherwise, this tool is going to block you for that, because they have a system that they can recognize, and they can recognize that you've bought this database from somewhere, and it's not going to accept, and they're going to block you for that. So just don't use random databases. Just upload the leads that you've genuinely generated by your activities. Okay. So getting back to the list page. So yeah, here you can see add contacts, and the next way to add contacts is just by clicking on the list, and again, you'll find the same button over here. Right, now let's see what do we have here. Okay, right. So apart from that, you can make it as a default list, meaning whatever forms you're trying to create, everything will be poured into that. So this becomes like a default list for everything, for all the campaigns. Right, next is settings. You see your contacts, you can show newsletters related to this particular list, and you can see what are the autoresponders you have created for this particular list. I'm just going to give you an example here. Okay, so if you look at Instagram influencer, there are 780 number of contacts that you have tried to are there in this particular list. Okay, when I click on it, all the contacts details I can just look here. Okay, and if I click more on the page, so here if you see, there's an opt-in proof, he joined on this at this particular time. So look at the detailing that you try to get from this particular tool. Okay, subscribe by API, it doesn't give you location, opt-in is single, phone number, source is ClickFunnels, and that's not it, contact activity. So the moment the lead got in, we sent an email saying it's time to run your Instagram scrolling into money rolling. That was a welcome message that we sent. So whatever activities, whatever emailers we send, and how the lead interacts with those emailers will also be shown in this particular tool. So here you see engagement score is neutral. That means if he starts clicking on every link that we send him in the emailers, his score will start increasing. He'll become a very high potential hot lead. Right, so scoring history is given and constant status is here. Right, so that's why email marketing tool for GetResponse is like the best. Okay, so yes, these are the few details, and here if you want to just delete from the list, or if you want to delete somebody, you can just go and do it manually as well, and otherwise you can delete the entire list itself. Okay, so here you go, you can just delete the entire list, and if you want to clean from time to time, you can always do that for you. So this is how you maintain your list. This is how you get started, and it's time for you to create your first list. If you already have contacts, create your first list, and then add it to the CSV file. If you don't have contacts, what we can do is we will create landing pages and we'll try to host it, and we'll try to learn that entire process of creating good converting landing pages, and we will generate the leads from that, and we'll send autorespondent emailers in my next classes. So that's it for today. If you have created your first list, go and comment below, done with my first list. Yeah, just comment below, done with my first list. In my next class, you will learn how to send newsletters to all your leads.